Welcome to another video on channel Masjid Munir. I hope you all are doing great and watching my videos. So today we are going to talk and discuss about the topic mensuration, which we have started already. So in the first video of this topic mensuration, we have learned and discussed about each and everything that is related to cone. So if you are new to my channel and if you really don't know what actually cone is and how we can find out the curved surface area and the total surface area of a cone really along with its volume, then I would really encourage you to please watch the playlist of mensuration where you will be finding my first video related to cone. So in today's video, we are going to talk about cylinder. So I am going to read this question once and then I will be identifying the main highlight and then I will be identifying the key portion of this question. It says a cylindrical tin has an internal diameter of 18 cm. It contains water to a depth of 13.2 cm. A heavy spherical ball bearing of diameter 9.3 cm is dropped into the tin. Find the new height of water in the tin. So it's a kind of a very confusing question. Obviously, once you are not sure about how actually the cylinder is and what's actually the spherical ball is, then obviously it's going to make a lot of trouble for you. So what I want you to have your fully focus on this question and watch this video till the end, and I can guarantee you that you are going to learn so many things. So what I'm going to do now, I'm going to break this question into different parts and then you will be seeing that how easy this question is going to become. So first of all, we are going to talk about cylinder, what actually cylinder is. So I am drawing a cylinder over here. My drawing is not actually good, but I always try my best to draw as much as best I can. So this is basically your cylinder having two flat surfaces and where we have circles and this curved surface area of a portion. So how we can draw a cylinder? So if just for the sake of your better understanding, what I am going to do, we have a rectangular sheet of paper. So if I'm going to fold it down like this, so that's how you are getting cylinder. You see, we have two circles along with this curved surface. So that's actually your basically cylinder looks like is. So now it says a cylindrical tin has an internal diameter of 18 centimeters. So this is basically a diameter of 18 centimeter. So I have one of my video related to the properties of circle in which I am explaining quite explicitly about the diameter and the different segments related to the circle. So you must need to watch that video as well, and I'm sure that you are going to have some more concept related to it. Obviously, cylinder consists of two circles. So if you are not really sure about what actually the circle is and what's actually the diameter is, then this is going to make a lot of trouble for you. Okay, so keeping things short, so this is basically your diameter of a cylinder, 18 centimeters. So I'm going to write it down. So diameter of cylinder is basically 18 centimeter. So if we divide it by 2, we know that we are going to get its radius, which is 9 centimeter. Okay, now it says contains water to a depth of 13.2 centimeter. So let's take for our simplicity that this is the water level that we are having at the moment. And the height of this water from here is 13.2 centimeter. Okay. Now a heavy spherical ball bearing of diameter 9.3 centimeter is dropped into it. So obviously once you are having a certain level or certain height of the water into a cylindrical tin and you are dropping a heavy ball or heavy object into this cylinder, the water level is going to be increased. That's a very simple experiment that we have did it so many times in our childhood, and you can see that if you are taking a cup and there is a certain level of water that you are having, and in that cup if you put another object, you will be seeing that its level is going to be increased. It's a very simple experiment where you can do it at your home. So this is the spherical ball. So this is basically the spherical ball I'm going to draw over here, and this is the cylinder that we have over here. Once we drop this spherical ball into the cylinder, the water level is going to be increased. So let's say these two cylinders doesn't look identical, obviously not. So I'm trying to make you understand. So pardon me if somewhere, you know, my drawing is not good. So keep having focus on my voice and try to understand what actually I'm talking about. So once you drop this spherical ball bearing into the water level is obviously going to be increased. So let's say initially it was this, now it's going to be increased like this. So the water level had a new height. So that's what we need to find. A heavy spherical ball bearing of diameter 9.3 centimeter. This is the diameter of the spherical ball, which is 9.3 centimeter. Once it is dropped into the tin, find the new height of the water. This is the new height that we need to find it out. So how we can do it? Okay, so first of all, we will be talking about this circle where we do not have any spherical ball, and we will be finding the volume of this cylindrical tin. Okay, so we know that the volume of a cylindrical tin formula is pi r square h. And how do we get that? In order to get the volume of any geometrical figure, you need to multiply the height with its base area. And we know that in the base of the cylinder, it's basically the circle. Mine circle is not good, but actually it's a circle. I told you with the rectangular sheet of my paper that this is a circle. So base area of this cylinder is pi r square, and the height of this cylinder is basically h. So once you multiply the base area with its height, you are always going to get volume, whether we are talking about cube or cuboid or pyramids or whatever the shape actually is. So V equals to V, by keeping the significant figure, we are taking the value of pi is 3.14, multiply r is basically 9 square, and multiply by height. So height is 13.2. Which height we are taking over here? It says a cylindrical tin has an internal diameter of 18 centimeter. It contains water to a depth of 13.2 centimeter. This is the height that I am taking at the moment. Okay, so let's take a help from calculator, and we will be solving this expression in first. 3.142 multiply by 9 square multiply by 13.2, plugging all these value at once, then you are going to get the volume, which is 3359.42 volume, and the unit was centimeter, so I'm going to put centimeter cube. Okay, so this is the volume of the water that we are having at the moment with the cylindrical ball. So now the another thing that we need to find out, the volume of this spherical ball. Okay, volume of a spherical ball. So what we have to find out that. Okay, so I'm going to erase my question. Okay, do we need anything? Yeah, diameter spherical ball, that's the diameter represented with capital R, which is 9.3 centimeter. We do need it that, so I'm not going to erase it. So let me write it over here, which actually we did. Okay, so let's find out now the volume of a spherical ball bearing. So volume of a spherical ball bearing is basically 4 over 3 pi r cube. I am writing with capital R in order to make the difference between these two. So plug in the value, 4 over 3 multiply pi is 3.142 multiply by R. So yes, this is diameter. This is diameter 9.3. So once you divide 9.3 by 2, you are going to get 4.65. Let me confirm, because I don't want to make mistake. So 9.3 divided by 2, you are going to get 4.65. So 4.65 cube. Okay, so I can write this volume 3359.42 centimeter cube. This will remind us that this is the volume of the water in the cylindrical tin. Okay, now simplify this expression by plugging all the values at once. We are getting 4 over 3 multiplied by 3.142 multiplied by R, which is 4.65, and then there is cube. Okay, once we plug in, we get 421.21. So volume, we are getting 421.21 centimeter cube. So this is the volume of a spherical ball bearing, and this is the volume. Okay, once we drop that spherical ball bearing into that cylinder, the water level is going to be increased. Obviously, now the original water, or the original volume that we were having without the spherical ball, plus this the volume of a spherical ball, they are going to merge with each other. So the total volume that we are having, 3359.42 plus 421.21. Okay, add these two values, 3359.42 plus 421.21. It's going to give you 3780.63 centimeter cube. So that's basically your volume of the water with the spherical ball bearing. Now we are not done yet. Because we need to find the new height of the water once we are dropping the spherical ball bearing. Obviously, we are dropping that spherical ball bearing into the cylinder. So we are going to use the same formula. The volume of a cylinder is pi r square h. Now we do know that what's the total volume of a cylinder. Once we drop the spherical ball into the cylinder, that's going to be 3780.63 equals to 3.142 multiplied by r. How much r is? The radius of a cylindrical tin was 9 centimeters. Since its diameter is 18, divided by 2. So 9 square multiplied by h. This h is now unknown. So it's a very simple expression that actually become. So what you are going to do now, we can erase this part and we can simplify. H is equals to 3780.63 divided by 3.142 multiplied by 9 squared. So let's solve this on calculator and let's see what we are getting. 3780.63 divided by 3.142 times 9 squared. So equal, so we are getting 14.86 centimeter. So that's the new height of a cylindrical tin. Sorry, that's the new height of a water once we drop this spherical ball bearing. So that's how we basically deal with these type of a question. That you see how easy it has become once we know that how to keep each and everything aligned. So what we did actually, let me give you a quick conclusion. We just first found out the volume of a cylindrical tin with the height of a water that was actually given, and then we found the volume of a spherical ball bearing and we added them together, from which we get the total volume. And now once we got the total volume and the height is unknown, and since we are talking about the cylinder, because the water level was increased in cylinder, so by using the same formula pi r square h, we are going to get the value of height, which is 14.86 centimeter. So I hope that this video was very helpful for you. So if you are new to my channel, then please do consider subscribing it and share this video as much as you can with your friends.